In the clash between two unbeaten teams, Carlton called up Brock McLean for his first game since round 20 last year. Essendon coach James Hurd said the Blues were strong right across the board and the Bombers' best chance lay in competing well at the contest. The Blues have scored at least 18 goals in their first three matches and they showed the quality in their ranks going from end to end.
Jamieson to Cruiser, quick one to Simpson running through the G, long ball to Betts, Hibbard goes back, uses his body well, Robinson takes it out of the air, onto the left boot, well done Mitch Robinson, coast to coast the Blues.
Despite their depleted stocks, the Bombers showed they were just as impressive, developing their attack from their end of the ground.
Gives it back to Monfries. Fast break is on. It needs to sit for Davey. Controlled that magnificently. Waltzes into the open goal and kicks Essendon's second.
Jeff Garlett landed his first with just his second possession before Mark Murphy kicked Carlton's third.
Onto the left he goes. Well played, Mark Murphy. Outstanding finish. Outstanding player.
Five goals last week, Eddie Betts booted through his first before Essendon cut the lead back to within a kick.
Fires the long ball, Cramery the target, doesn't need him. Outstanding long ball from Jake Melksham and we're back to within 4 points.
Andrew Carazzo's impressive season came to a halt when he went to hospital with a suspected broken collarbone, while Michael Hurley nudged Essendon in front straight after quarter time.
Hurley's kicked four goals for this season, another at 50% coming into the game. He's improved the ledger the right way.
The Bombers moved further ahead when 37-year-old fullback Dustin Fletcher took aim in game number 351.
A long ball, a really long ball, a very popular kick from a very popular man.
Stuart Cramery missed a sitter that would have made it five straight Essendon majors before Davey had the Blues in the spin as he put the Bombers 22 points clear.
Squeezes a kick to Jenner, knocks it to Davey. This could be a really clever goal. Davey kicks, advantage the call, outstanding Bombers.
The Blues kept goalless in the second term as Essendon 59 led Carlton 31 at half time. Coach Brett Ratten forced to repel the Bombers' attack with plans B or C. Betts got them going soon after the long break.
A team lifter and maybe a morale lifter for him as well. And Carlton get the start they needed.
After five consecutive Essendon behinds, Brent Stanton collected a major.
Brent Stanton fixes that.
Patrick Ryder and Cramery added two more to make it nine of the previous 10 goals for the Bombers.
He chips, he goals. It's suddenly the Bombers by 41 points at the MCG.
Cramery made it a 47-point game at the final change. Betts replied for Carlton early in the final quarter.
Waits around the place, he flies, can't get to it. Betts can, Betts goals, bang, bang.
Cramery equaled his career-best haul of four goals before McLean opened his account for the Blues.
Kick smothered by a couple of Blues, ends up with Cruiser quickly to Waite and then to Brock McLean. And he kicks his first of season 2012.
Betts made it four goals from seven possessions.
Waite, a big fly. Eddie Betts waiting down for goal number four. Maybe there is time. It's back to 30 points.
First gamer Corey Dell'Olio made a good first impression.
Tackle terrific, Dell'Olio.
Chris Judd had the door ajar for a late Carlton rally. Four goals down with 8 minutes to play. Essendon shut it before you could enjoy saying, come on the Blues.
Dell'Olio, the handball to Monfries, outstanding. And Monfries finishes. How quick was that?
Cramery delivered the exclamation mark in a convincing victory.
Kick on its way. Cramery goals. That's the ball game and his fifth.
Essendon, four straight wins to open the season for the first time since 2000. Full-time Essendon 15-19-109, Carlton 11-13-79.